So, we know how our parsing chart starts on the left. Chart 0 starts with S goes to I haven't seen anything yet, but I want an E, and I'm starting from chart position 0. It'd be really nice if, after all T tokens in the input, we've got I have totally seen an E, and I'm done with it now, starting from position 0 in the input. So I know the start of parsing, and I know the end of parsing, but there's a slight huge, massive gulf in here, the excluded middle of parsing, that I just don't know how to construct. If only I had some intuition for it. Let's go see how that plays out. We need to know how to make additional entries in our chart. For example, we have S goes to dot E. What do? Can we bring some more stuff in? In the examples I've shown you, we've added a few more things to chart position 0. I'm going to formally tell you how to do that. I'm going to formalize it using some abstract mathematics. Let's say that we're looking at chart position I. This means we've seen I tokens in the input. And one of the things currently in that chart is the following parse state. S goes to E plus dot E coming from state J. This dot means we're expecting to see an E in the future. This is the future, this is the past. So I'm going to need to look in our grammar for all the rules that start with E. Because if E goes to elephant, then I should be expecting to see an elephant in chart state I. If E goes to eggplant, I should be expecting to see an eggplant in chart state I. We need to find all of the rules E goes to something in the grammar and somehow bring them in. So let me make this very generic to handle all possible situations. Let's say that we've got X goes to AB.CD coming from position J in chart I. Normally, for grammars, I always draw non-terminals in blue and terminals in black, but I'm going to leave this A, B, C, and D. I don't know if they're terminals or non-terminals. I don't know what they are. In fact, they may even be empty. A may be nothing. B may be nothing. I'm going to be as generic as I can to handle all the possibilities, so I'm not pinning these down to being either terminals or non-terminals. But I do note that our dot is right in front of C. So I'm going to look in my grammar for all rules C goes to something. A could be empty, B could be empty, PQR could be empty, or they could be terminals, or they could be non-terminals. Could be anything. So for every such grammar rule, C goes to PQR, C goes to anything, kumquat, that doesn't start with a C, C goes to chevalier, we believe, ultimately, that we're going to see a C in the future. If C goes to carbon, then we should expect to see carbon in the immediate future. But we don't want to forget that we made this decision starting in chart state I, that conceptually there were I tokens before us that we're sort of forgetting about or putting off to the side, because even though it looks like this dot is right to the left, there are I tokens we've already seen in order for us to get to this point. So we add C goes to dot PQR. We haven't seen any part of C yet, but we think we might. It's a possibility. We're leaving our options open. We came to this idea from chart state I. That's how many sort of hidden pieces of input we're eliding before the dot. We add that to chart I. We do this for every grammar rule that starts with a C. If there are 5 grammar rules that start with a C, we're going to add 5 things to chart I. Formally, this operation of bringing in everything that C could become, because we're expecting to see a C, is known as predicting. I predict that because we want to see a C, and C goes to cantaloupe, that we are going to see a cantaloupe. It's also called computing the closure, a more technical term from language theory. We're right before a C. Any rule that has C on the left-hand side should be brought in to close the state so that all possibilities are considered.